Hello everybody, hope you all are well. In this video we are going to learn about implicant, prime implicant, that is PI, essential prime implicant EPI, redundant prime implicant RPI, and selective prime implicant SPI for sum of product side. Okay, for product of sum side we will be learning about false implicants, false prime implicants FPI, essential false prime implicant EFPI, redundant false prime implicant RFPI, and finally selective false prime implicant SFPI. Okay, now coming to the upper one. Okay, I'm starting with this graph, then we'll go to this graph. Okay, so here you know how to plot the graph for four variable, that already I have done on both the side. Okay, so before going to this graph, let's understand what is an implicant. Individual ones are implicants. So this individual ones, you can see these are all implicants. Okay, when this form group, okay, this group is also called as subcubes in some of the book. So when they form subcubes or groups, these are called as prime implicants. So if you see this graph, how many prime implicants I'm having? One, this quad is another two, this is pair is three, this is four, this is five. So four pairs, one quad, so five prime implicant I'm having. Okay, now that is PI I got. Now how many EPIs I'm having? So EPI's definition is what? If at least a single one of a prime implicant, if at least a single one, so it may be more than a single one also. Okay, hear it properly. If at least a single one of a prime implicant is not a part of any other prime implicant, then that prime implicant is an essential prime implicant. Okay, so let us see this one. In this pair, this one is not part of any other prime implicant, so this is an EPI. Though this one is a pair with other, this quad, but this one, at least a single one he is saying, so this one is not a part. Okay, so this is an EPI. Similarly, this is also EPI, this is EPI, this is EPI. So here I am having 1, 2, 3 and 4 EPIs I am having, right? And the center one is an RPI. Why this is an RPI? What is the definition of this? It says that all the ones of an prime implicant, if is a part of at least a single EPI, if the one of an prime implicant, if the ones of, not one, ones of an prime implicant is a part of at least a single EPI, then that PI or prime implicant is an RPI, is called redundant prime implicant. So here you can see I have four ones, all the ones are part of EPIs. Okay, at least a single EPI is taking care of the ones. Okay, all the ones. So this quad is an RPI. Okay, now coming to this side, you can observe I have one prime implicant over here, this is a prime implicant, this, this, this and this. So you can easily say these two are EPIs because a single ones are not covered by any other prime implicant. Then what is SPI? If the definition says that if it is not an RPI, not an EPI, this is an SPI, selective prime implicant. So you see this one, this prime implicant, okay, this is not an EPI, not an RPI. This is called by EPI, but this is not called by EPI, so this cannot be an RPI. Okay, and this is not at all an EPI, so this is an SPI. Same thing lies for this one, as well as this one. So I have four SPIs over here. Okay, this is the part of SOP, sum of product. Coming to product of sum or max term equations. Okay, the false term will come into play. False implicants, false prime implicants, everything remains the same. Only false term is coming into play because we are dealing with zeros now. Okay, so coming to this one first. Okay. This one I'm taking because you presently understand here I have not, the empty boxes should be filled with one, I have not done with one because it will be confusing. Here the same thing, I have not filled with zero because it will be confusing. Starting with over here, for EFPI, essential false prime implicant I'm getting. See, when I make quad for this, this, this and this quads, you can see this zero is not covered by any other PIs, this zero is not covered by any other PIs, this zero and this zero is not covered by any other PIs. So I have four essential false prime implicant over here. Okay, I'm focusing on zeros. Similar case over here, you can see this blue lines, you can see 1, 2, 3 and 4 not covered by any other PI. So these are my EFPIs, and the corner one is my RFPI, redundant, because this is an quad I got. Okay, that is false prime implicant I got. Okay, but the zeros are taken care by EPIs. One, this EPI is taking care of this zero is taken care by this EPI, this zero by this EPI, this zero by this EPI. So all the zeros are covered by at least one EPI is taking care of the zeros. So this becomes my RFPI. Okay, coming over here, the green color you can see is SFPI, that is selective false prime implicant, because it is not an EFPI or it's not an RFPI, then it will be SFPI. Okay, so you can see this is an SFPI because this zero and this zero. Okay, open, you can see this two forming a pair. This is an SFPI again because it's not an EFPI nor an RFPI. Okay, so this is an SFPI, similarly this one and this one, because what the definition says that if it is not an EFPI, so let catch one. I'm catching this one, this pair, I'm catching it. Okay, for explanation, see, this zero is taken care by this, okay, blue one. So this is an EFPI essential, but this zero, this one is not taken care by any EFPI. Okay, so this is not an RPI or rather RFPI. Okay, because all the zero should be taken care by EFPI, you know, then that will be RFPI. So this is not an RFPI, and rather this is not also an EFPI also, because both the zeros are taken care of by other prime implicants. So this is not an RPI, not an EFPI. So this will obviously be SFPI. Similarly, for all the greens, you can see this two, this two, this and this, this two and this and this. Okay, you can have a check. Okay, now this zeros are basically individual zeros. Like I have given a point over here. So individual zeros are false implicants. Okay, when they form subcubes or groups, they becomes false prime implicants. Okay, those things only I have mentioned it over here. So I hope I have made you clear about this implicants, prime implicants, SL prime implicants, redundant prime implicants, and SLT prime implicants from SOP side and from POS side, false prime implicants, and EFPI, RFPI, SFPI. Okay. So thank you for watching my video.